Hello, Zogo here with another YouTube video. Today we play Lich Bazaar, and since the armor introduction, Lich Bazaar is pretty strong. Like, I have good results with this hero, a lot of first and second places. Overall, a really high average, and I want to explain to you why this hero is so strong right now, so maybe you can consider playing this hero as well and gaining that juicy free MMR. But first of all, let's talk about the hero power. The hero power is that you take 2 damage and then you gain a coin, like most of you guys probably know. And a lot of things that especially newer players are always worried about: how often should I hero power? As a rule of thumb, you should hero power in the early game every turn, and then afterwards you can hero power till you're at like 20 HP or 22. That's a good number to stay on. Since damage cap introduction, you could even consider hero powering till you're at like 18 HP or 16, if no one is dead yet. And the curve you want to play is actually really flexible. You can play almost every curve on this hero because the coins fit really nicely. As long as the coin fits, you can play the curve. My personal favorite curve is the one that I play in this video as well, where you buy on 3 gold, you buy on 4 gold 2 minions, and on 5 gold you buy 1 minion and level, on 6 gold you level as well, on 7 gold you level. So you are really early on tier 4. Another thing you want to pay attention to is the tribes that are in the game. Especially pirates, elementals and demons are really nice for Lich Bazaar, but also Quillborn mechs are nice. You want to have 4 drops that are strong in the pool that you can just pick up. And that's either Avenge cards or strong standalone cards like Ring Matron or Peggy, because Peggy has synergy with the hero power. You buy a Peggy, then you hero power, and then you gain +1/+1 stats for free as well at the same time, which is really nice. And what you look to do from there is you want to level aggressive if you can, or you want to stay on tier 4 and build a comp there. It really depends how the game looks from there, but that's always a nice spot to end up on. And the way you can look at Lich B in general is you can compare that hero really well to a Barov, to a more consistent Barov, since you are not relying on ties. And since you have like 10 armor, you have like 5 coins at least for free now, which makes the hero really strong. So basically the 4 drop pool is strong in general, armor being in the game and damage cap being in the game makes Lich Bazaar spike earlier than any other hero, which makes her gain an advantage in the early game and never let go of it and snowball that lead. And in this game especially, I have a really nice end game. And now I hope you enjoy the video. And see you next time around. And don't forget to join the giveaway by commenting, liking, subscribing to have a chance to win a Winter Veil bundle. I will draw the winner in one week from now. And now, see you guys. Till next time. Okay, this looks like Ty at least. Yeah. Straight to tier 7? Huge pickup! NINE! I had to play this last! Whew, saved. Now we are cooking with gas. I'm really strong for this turn. Nosy? Nah, the problem is that Doomsayer is too good with Imp Mama. Wait, he stole my scaling and he optimized it with a Big Fernal and a Weaver. Dude, this guy's me! What the fuck? I fight myself, you can't win against that. Milk me more. Here. Milkiness! Felbert! Fuck. It's fine. I'm only in damage cap range. Nothing can go wrong from here. That's my Olga, at least. I actually messed up. Nein! I'll save these ones for later. Fuck, man! You can turn this around. I thought I can buy both. Junge! Brain! Warum funktionierst du nicht? No, man! Oh, God! That makes me so upset, actually, that I was so stupid there. I don't know why I thought I can buy both! I calculated the one gold in the wrong way! I calculated it that I can buy both because I'm plus one thanks to Lich B, but I was at two gold. Why couldn't I realize that? Oh man, that makes me so sad. So bad. That was bad. Yes. You're good at this. No reason to wrap it in, bro. What did he have? He had Ursul and some other stuff, Little Rick, but I don't know what else. I don't want to risk it either. Actually, I can buy it for free, basically, and scale something up. Order, lol. This delays him for a long time, and I know he has at least bronze ones, and if he has Nadina, if he attacks first, then he doesn't get value. If he attacks second, then he got me good, I guess. Fuck him. Time to rewatch a classic. How's Yazira on 40? I don't know. I expected her to be giga strong then. But it seems like I was fine. All along. Thank you. That's my last straw. Big Furnace. I knew you had Gold Weaver at least. Monka W, he was coming for me. I got Ghost now again. Ooh. He was actually pretty strong. Way stronger than I assumed. I was like, I'll mop the floor with him. Okay, great.
You're down a minion and up a goal. The scourge will consume you. Good battle, friend.
Log on his way to fuck up his sleeping schedule. Man, and this guy was way weaker than I assumed. I was like, maybe he isn't that weak. He plays Cook and he got killed by Omo. I did the ordering mistake too. I should have sold Little Rick there. My order sucks right now. Like, I play this game not that well, which makes me upset because I played the other games well. Roach to top 4 at least. Now a Slayer comes. Hero power copium.
You down a minion and up a gold. My seal for Argus. Do some damage. We must stand together, united for Dalaran.
I'm not safe from that though. That sucks. Why did you keep the wreck? Here, keeping the wreck made sense. Before, I should have sold it. Since I want to play 6 units.
I think you can.
Why not taunt one? If he has Wildfire, I can still play around it by having Baron there. I'd rather have two taunted to make sure I play around Cyclone. Can only get fucked if I run into plants early on, right? If I proc his Amalgadon and run into plants. The only problem is Quilbos are banned in this lobby. So, it's really hard for me to tech against Zap. I would need green some for that. And next time he will tech against me. If there is a next time. Dude, can you kill the 3 attack Amalgadon for the fans? That has poison. No, Amalgadon will live. At least we live as well, so it's fine. I don't think I can beat him though. Maybe I can, I just need golden Katka, another Katka, and green some. So basically it's coming home. We must stand together united for Dalaran. I could go for golden Eliza in this lobby too. I'll need the attack, I think. Go ahead and hire one of these recruits. I'll freeze in case I triple the Scallywag here and float. Actually, I will buy a Molten Rock, I guess. I can either make the Scallywag golden, the Eliza golden, this Scallywag golden, or the Sky Pirate golden. Like, I can make this golden too here, for example. It worked. I can play one more Scallywag, which is really huge. I can play better on Zap now. And now I have a 50-50 for Eliza. Okay. The funny thing is, next time I will always make it gone because now the Sky Pirates are gone. Why sell Rack? You're actually right. I forgot that. BB Bat. Fuck! That's actually one way I could scale. Fuck, man. That was a really good point, though. I usually don't forget about that. I don't know why I forgot about it in this spot. But thanks for bringing it up. Now we learn for the future. BBBat is really good as a player. What do you mean? He's the Giga Nuts. Have a copium idea. What about we play a Scallywag and play green sometime? If he has Zap, then I have a 50-50. I kinda like it, honestly. Okay, I found the Katka now, though.
A good tactical choice.
I think I like this more. No, he can't take that against me in the next fight too. I should have positioned my... Actually, I have to position my Baron like this then. We won the flip, who cares? I need to win multiple fights against him, so I have to take this risk. So I can play around Zap. Now he can't fuck me anymore. And Golden Eliza was also huge. Because I get enough stats this way. Dude, this green sum actually... How often did it proc? It already proc 4 times. in the side. And the second, this is the third Scallywag coming. Is Chetka effect stacking? It is. That's why 4 Khadgars is really strong. Nice board. I mean, his board isn't that nice, honestly. He's not that oppressive for turn 14 on an elemental comp. He could easily have 200-200 stats. He has one big dong, a Felvet, and a Urza, and everything else is pretty small in his comp. Are you kidding me, dude? He takes 5 damage? What a robbery. But if he buys Acolyte, will he kick you? Kinda. But that's why I play 3 Scallywags. It's hard to kick 3 Scallywags. But he will probably go for it. I will hold the zap for a while. Is it ever selfless? You can take selfless too. But not in this spot. Like, it's not good against what my opponent does. That green sub was so clutch, man. And the Scallywag Tony setup was also really good. I'm happy about the endgame that I did. I wasn't happy about my order, but endgame was good. Yeah, at least he needs to play one Acolyte or Void Lord. Some dude said you lost when you was with 28 HP tier 4. Yeah, that's what I said. Leveling aggressive doesn't mean you lose. That means you sacrifice HP to be strong in the long con. Check, wait. He cucked my third one. That was bad for me. But it shouldn't matter, right? I'm already too huge. Yeah, nothing dies. Nice. I was scared that my Khadgar could die, and then I don't lethal him. Force Khadgar is always better, because triple Baron plus golden Baron gives you basically already 9. The Scallywag gives you triples the summoning, so you have 3. Then the Khadgar triples that, so you have 9. And the third Khadgar basically doubles that again, so you have 18. This Khadgar is such a big power spike.